Around the world, requirements for microtunneling projects have grown in economical and safety aspects. With over 40 years of experience in tunneling, Heron Connect's expertise has been beneficial in developing this state-of-the-art product line of separation systems, which are an important factor in every successful microtunneling operation. The HKS, or Heron Connect separation systems, are especially designed for microtunneling operations with slurry mud conveyance in various ground conditions that separate and remove the excavated soil from the bentonite suspension, and then feed the clean suspension back to the slurry circuit. Depending on the tunnel diameter, excavation rate, viscosity of slurry, and geological conditions, HK offers efficient separation solutions. The HKS 100, with 100 cubic meters per hour maximum slurry capacity, for a typical TBM outer diameter of up to 1200 millimeters. The HKS 150, with 150 cubic meters per hour maximum slurry capacity for a typical TBM outer diameter of up to 1800 millimeters. The HKS 300, with 300 cubic meters per hour maximum slurry capacity for a typical TBM outer diameter of up to 2400 millimeters. And the HKS 500, with 500 cubic meters per hour maximum slurry capacity for a typical TBM outer diameter of up to 3800 millimeters. In the following computer animation, we illustrate the operation of different HKS systems suitable for a wide range of geological conditions from very coarse to ultra-fine. Shown here is the basic HKS 300, which consists of a primary screen separation and two-stage vacuum-assisted cyclone process for fine solids removal down to 20 microns. This equipment is equipped with a 20-foot process tank where the hydrocyclone pumps and the control panel are located. The tank is divided into three compartments. The slurry is pumped from the TBM to the HKS's primary linear motion shaker, where the coarse material is removed. The scalping shaker is supplied with 15 high-resistance polyurethane panels, giving a total screen area of 4.8 square meters. The screens were designed to process high flows with big amounts of material. Compared to HDD technology and vertical drilling, the volume of material coming from the tunnel boring machines is much higher. The screens separate the coarse material from the fluid and convey it to disposal. The screened slurry flows into the first compartment of the process tank. The slurry fluid is then pumped to the 15-inch hydrocyclones for secondary separation, down to 35 microns. Fluid velocity inside the body of the cyclone creates centrifugal force. The conical section increases the force, causing large particles to settle. Solids accumulate at the bottom. When the weight of the solids exceeds the elastic force of the underflow regulator, the solids dump. Cleaned fluid and smaller particles are caught in the upward spiral and exit through the vortex finder into the overflow pipe. Heron Connect separation plants use high-pressure hydrocyclones, which, due to their form and length, permit the slurry going in to reach high centrifugal velocity, which makes them have a very low cutting point. The inner of the cyclones are made up of polyurethane, which also makes them very long-lasting. The cyclone underflow is discharged through the urethane underflow regulator that opens and closes sequentially, subject to the solids loading. The solid's underflow exits to the high G-force linear motion shaker screen for dewatering. This dewatering screen deck uses a combination of polyurethane and metal screens. The material coming out of the 15-inch cyclone buildup, the so-called filter cake, which later on is used as a filter for smaller particles coming out of the desilter cyclone. The lighter materials that are smaller than 35 microns exit through the cyclone overflow and are discharged to the second compartment of the process tank. The slurry fluid is then pumped to the 6-inch hydrocyclones in the desilter stage. This stage can separate particles of up to 20 micrometers. The separated material goes out through the underflow and on top of the filter cake. The whole filter cake then moves up through the shaker and in the process gets dewatered for an optimal dry output. The lighter particles that are smaller than 20 microns exit through the cyclone overflow and are discharged to the third compartment of the process tank. Through an overflow, the slurry is transferred to the storage tank, where it can be pumped back to the TBM. During pipe change or ring building sections, the water level inside the process tank lowers so that there is no transfer to the sedimentation tank. The plant will keep running in bypass mode, cleaning the 20 cubed meters inside. For geological conditions with mainly coarse, sandy, and silty material, the shown solution is capable to keep the slurry functional for operation. As geological conditions change to finer silts and clays, further separation is required. The HKS Fine Stage is a supplementary cyclone stage to the HKS plants to separate silt particles of up to 10 micrometers. It uses 4-inch hydrocyclones and a shaker with woven steel screens to dewater the material. This stage has a capacity of 400 cubic meters per hour and improves significantly the quality of the slurry. The HKS belt scraper, shown on top of the HKS 300, is used as the first line of defense against hydrated sticky clay, which normally binds the screens of the separation plant. A special belt conveyor removes with a cartridge screen belt system made of polyurethane the clay clumps before entering the separation. It is compatible with all of the HKS plants. For clay particles that are already diluted in the slurry, HK also offers special designed centrifuges and fluctuation units to prevent the density of the slurry of going up. One of the main strengths of Heron Connect separation technology for microtunneling is its adjustability when used in heterogeneous ground conditions. Through its modular design, optimum adaptation is possible, which enables fast handling and saves costs.